Coming to you from our GIS studios, I am Anicia Antoine, and this is your midday news brief. On the heels of the announcement of the common entrance examinations results, the public was urged to refrain from becoming exam focused. Minister for Education, Innovation, Gender Relations and Sustainable Development, Honorable Dr. Gail Rigobert, indicated that while results are significant, there are even more pressing matters requiring attention. Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Education, Innovation, Gender Relations and Sustainable Development, Michelle Charles, recently announced that the Center for Adolescent Renewal and Education, CARE, agreed to accept 50 of the students who obtained between 9% and 30% in the 2019 Common Entrance Examinations and will allow them to follow the Junior Life program at the CARE Institute. The Minister for Education also urged parents to take advantage of this opportunity. The national mean for the 2019 Common Entrance Examination stood at 60.09%, and the composite scores ranged from 9% being the minimum to 97% being the maximum. The Ministry of Education hosted a 3-day disaster risk reduction summer program for students from ages 8 to 10 in schools located in Castries and environs. The students participated in hands-on activities such as basic first aid and CPR classes and were given an opportunity to visit the NEMO headquarters to gain insight on the role of the organization. The Ministry of Education also collaborated with the Fire Service Department to educate students on the various fire hazards. Brenda St. Helen, a teacher at the Ave Maria School, stressed on the importance of educating students on both man-made and natural resources. The Disaster Risk Reduction Summer Program commenced on Monday, July 8th and culminated on Wednesday, July 10th, 2019. The Ambassador of the Kingdom of Norway to the Organization of Eastern Caribbean States, OECS, presented her credentials to the Director General of the OECS on Monday, July 1st, 2019 at a ceremony held at the OECS Commission at Montfortune, Castries. The ambassador outlined several avenues of cooperation that Norway is keen to explore with the OECS, especially in the areas of marine management, biodiversity preservation, the effects of climate change, and the elimination of marine litter. Both parties agreed to work as expeditiously as possible in pursuit of common objectives and deepening relations. This has been your midday news brief. Thank you for watching.